Other way, babe. Don't point it at yourself. Like that.
Oh, are you sure? Oh, okay, I thought it was this way. Okay.
Today is all about gender reveal.
So, we have sent out a family member to go get these giant confetti cannons.
And a little hiccup. Yes, guys. Our first plan for our gender reveal went out the window.
The confetti is literally going across the lake.
Yeah, Paul's parents may need to move after this.
Another day, and we're coming at you with another fun journey. Today is all about gender reveal, and I know a lot of you guys have been asking, when is this vlog coming out? What are you having? We're super excited. Well, you guys will know at the end of this, so stay tuned till the very, very end.
If you guys could not tell, we're wearing long sleeves again. It has been freezing cold in Florida. I say freezing cold, it's only like 60 degrees out. But for us here in Florida, 2 to 3 days of freezing cold is a lot.
Yeah, like, we are in long sleeve. I mean, I got like a hoodie dress on right now because it's a little chilly out.
Guys, do not forget that in the description below, you will find our Amazon baby registry. Nothing, absolutely nothing is required, but everything is appreciated. This is a new journey for me and Janice, and any help that we get from you guys is truly, truly appreciated from the bottom of our hearts. Now, you guys are nice enough to send us a token of appreciation, so we want to send you guys something back as well. So the first 50 people who send us gifts through our Amazon baby registry, we will send you guys back something as well. Now we're gonna send you a nice personalized card saying thank you, as well as a small token of appreciation. It is something similar to like our merch. It's one of our cute designs, but this is something that we haven't released yet. And the exact item that we will be sending out, we will not offer on our merch store ever.
Exclusive! So this is
very exclusive, just to say thank you guys from the bottom of our hearts.
But we have to update you guys on a little hiccup with our original plan for our gender reveal. Yes, guys, our first plan for our gender reveal went out the window and it did not work out as planned. And literally this whole entire week, I have pretty much been really sad, down, and just like kind of upset. And Paul's just like, let's turn it around and make it worth its while. Cause this, you know, you do a gender reveal once in a blue moon. So this is something we definitely have to do and should enjoy. If you guys have been watching for a while now, we have been saying we were gonna do a gender reveal picnic. A while ago, I did see that there's this company here in Orlando that, you know, does beautiful picnics, and it seemed like a great idea, you know, because of COVID, pandemic, social distancing. I was like, this is a great idea.
Yeah, and we definitely thought it was, and there's a company that we reached out to. They were more than happy to help, and what seemed like an amazing thing turned into a nightmare.
Yeah, Paul got really upset.
You have no idea how pissed
he was.
I got by how this company handled things. Not at the beginning, when it was already too late to replan or get our money back or change anything. Like, it was bad.
Okay, so let us break it down for you. We had everything scheduled to a T. Everything was perfection. I was super excited for our plan. And the night before, like around 10, 11 o'clock at night, event coordinator contacts me. This is where Paul got really mad real quick.
So everything was planned. Janice had a lot of things planned and gave him the information. And, you know, we told him that we wanted to have this picnic at a certain park in Orlando. And they're like, great, no problem. I know exactly everything. Don't worry. Everything is planned to a T. And we were like, perfect. Like,
specific details that we wanted for this, such as we wanted social distancing. We wanted to be in an area that wouldn't be crowded.
Yeah.
And we also said, of course, if any of you guys do or do not know, Paul has Crohn's disease. So there's certain things we have to really consider, such as the sun. He's pretty much a vampire. He cannot be in the sun for more than like 10 minutes.
Yeah, and that's because of the medication that I take for my Crohn's disease. It puts me at a much higher risk for skin cancer.
And what's that percentage?
Like 300% higher risk than a normal person.
We literally have Paul stay away from the sun because I don't want my baby to get skin cancer.
My dermatologist tells me all the time, they're like, on the medications that you're on, you have to stay out of the sun. Whenever you go in the sun, always wear sunblock. Like literally in my car door, I have the spray on sunblock. So whenever I get out, I just really quickly just my ears, my neck, my arms, every single day.
So I let this coordinator know all of these details. Like, hey, we're immunocompromised. We have health issues, pandemic, and you know, the company seemed very understanding and knew where we were coming from. Until the night before at like 10, 11 o'clock at night.
What ended up happening was the night before, it was over 10 p.m. at night. Me and Janice are laying in bed. We're just like, oh, we're super excited for tomorrow. It's going to be amazing. She texts us and says, hey, where do you want to do your
picnic?
And we're just like, at the park we told you about, you said that you have a location. And she goes, oh, okay, hold on. And we're just like, wait, what?
She sends us a location right next to the dog park.
When she means right next to, literally like 20 feet from the fence of the dog park.
She was aware that we had a service dog. And she was just like, well, this is a great area for you to be. It's pet friendly. And I'm just like,
I don't need pet friendly.
Yeah, I was just like, thank you so much, but that's a very big distraction for my service dog. Like, that's not going to happen. It just made it seem like everywhere else wasn't going to accept us because of our dog. And I was like, he's a service dog. He's medically required. At this time, me and Paul are shaking in our boots because we're like,
it is like 11 something at night right now. So yeah. We start going. She's like, here, we can go to this park in this location here. And I'm like, this is not something you handle at 10 o'clock at night, the night before someone's picnic. Like, this is something you talk about a week, too. And we had this, like, planned 4 weeks ahead of time.
A month before,
you know?
Yeah.
So we're like, that's something that you handle weeks in advance.
Just thinking about it, I'm getting a headache. Like, oh, my God.
No, it genuinely pissed me off because I was like, what happens if we didn't answer? What happens if we were both asleep already? What would have happened then? The next day, we find this out while we're on our way to the picnic that we don't have a location or the location is not what we can handle because of the dog or because of the dog park or anything. So we're just like, what the hell? So from there, it just spiraled out of control.
Yeah, we're just giving different locations. If we change the locations last minute, we were going to get charged an additional amount. And I'm just, I got very overwhelmed, stressed, upset. And I was just like, this is not how it should be right now.
It was very stressful. Janice started tearing up and I was like, oh hell no, you are not going to be making my wife cry the day before our gender reveal, the day of, because you're being difficult and you don't. And I was like, if this is like your business, your thing that you do, you would think that you have a better kind of like set strategy to deal with it. Not the night before at 10 o'clock at night. At least text me in the morning, the day before.
Yeah.
And you know, give me like 24 hours, like, all right, fine, I can figure it out. 10 o'clock at night, I'm in bed, I'm like half asleep. So then now I'm like, great, now I'm like here on my phone looking up
parks. We were exhausted having to take that on. And then from there the next day, we had a time limit to figure out the finalization where we wanted to go.
Oh, that was another one. She was like, here, I need to know by like noon or by like 11 a.m. I need to know super like, we're like, what the hell? Like, now you're giving me even more time limit restrictions when you're the one who messed up and should have talked to us about this at least a couple of days ago. And then all the locations she was sending us were not what we had talked to her about. At the beginning, before we paid her, she was like, I know exactly where to put you, exactly that's going to be perfect for everything that you need. So that's why we felt super comfortable with it. And then now come to realize after we paid and it comes down to actually do the picnic, it's the same spots in the middle of a park where there's a bunch of people.
Oh, that was another issue. The options she gave us, I mean, it was crowded. Every single option she gave us, she's like, yeah, but it may be full or there may be other people there. Heavy foot traffic. And we're just like, that's not what we want.
And the worst part is she told us, I know exactly how to help you and put it where there'll be no one. Like, she made it seem like she knew the exact location. Like, I got you.
It was a lot. So, yeah, we canceled and we're like, oh well, we didn't get much of a refund back, sadly, which is perfectly fine. Whatever. What's the point of making money? You know what I mean? Like, you make some, you waste some, and you get more. So we had this wonderful picnic planned. I mean, beautiful decorations, everything to a T, and it all fell through. And I was pretty upset this whole entire week. You know, I've been feeling down and just feeling like, I don't know, nothing was going right. And I think Paul's mom definitely noticed, and she's just like, let's not let this ruin this whole entire pregnancy journey. Let's do something, just us, something cute in the house. And Paul's mom was super sweet, pretty much kind of like set up the whole entire house. And I'm excited to go over there. It's super sweet that your mom can support us. So guys, we are gonna take you on that journey and finally find out if we're having a boy or a girl. Write in the comments if you are team boy or team girl. Tell us what you want us to have and see if you agree with the final results. It's not like you can change it anyway.
Seriously.
It is a windy day right now and all the balloons are getting destroyed, but it was still cute when it lasted, guys. But we're getting ready to find out what we have.
So we have sent out a family member to go get these giant confetti cannons, and all we have to do is grab and twist and they just...
And it's gonna say what we got. Ready, guys?
Let's. Anytime there's pyrotechnics involved, I'm excited.
Let's do it. All the balloons are going everywhere. Ah! It's perfectly fine.
All right, let's do this.
Alrighty, guys. So we're about to get started. Ah, I don't know what I want, but we have the cannon here. And
other way, but don't point it at yourself like that.
Oh, you sure? Okay, I thought it was this way. Okay, so. Make sure we're doing this right. Ready?
All right, so all you're gonna do is twist.
Twist.
All right.
Don't point it at me.
That neighbor's gonna be pissed.
Your neighbor's
the confetti is literally going across the lake to the houses over there. The confetti.
Let's hope no one's mad about that. Whoa, guys, did you see it? A girl!
Our little fushy.
We're gonna show you guys how, Paul's parents may need to move after this because the next door neighbor
would be pissed, bro.
Let's look.
So the balloons have not survived much, but look at the grass now. This is only like half of everything. The other half flew up in the air. There's some out here.
There's a lot.
Oh yeah, sorry Alvin. We love you, bro.
But look at guys, it's a girl! Oh my gosh, it's all pink! Oh, I wanted a boy so badly! But we get what we get and we enjoy the journey. Now, since we're done finding out what the gender is, it's time to have Paul's mom's delicious food. This looks like it's keto. Oh, it is keto. Look at that. You could just tell. Oh, a lot of veggies. Guys, if you want to enjoy good food, always go to your mother-in-law's.
The best food possible.
Paul, how do you feel about that?
I love it. I have a little princess now.
Guys, I'm gonna be honest, I really wanted a boy. Like 100% a boy. All the clothes I was already picking out were for boys. So
yeah.
Well, now I have a new, different journey to take on. I don't think the world can handle a mini-me. Like, let's be honest. That's why I'm nervous.
I've had training for the last 10 years being with Janice. I can handle a mini version of her.
There should only be one Janice on this planet.
Our little Sushi's a little baby girl. Okay,
what do you guys think? What do you guys think of this belly? Ooh, it's getting there. It's getting there.
There's a baby bump.
Oh, so guys, we're excited to have a princess. Can you imagine, like, our family, how it's going to be? Now, also thinking about I have a mini-me, I also have a mini-me that can go up against Paul, too, so.
Whatever Janice wants something, she just has to tell our daughter, Daddy, can I have, you get whatever you want, that, whatever
ask
you want.
Ask for sushi, ask for sushi.
Sushi it is.
So guys, we're gonna go enjoy Paul's mom's wonderful cooking to celebrate this wonderful event, and we hope you guys enjoyed. So guys, for now, adieu and goodbye.